Hello, it's me again, and I'm here with the drill paddle. Now, is this thing good? Is it amazing or what? Well, guess what? I'm here with my Ryobi 18 volt, and we put it on here. Now, what I've learned, battery lasts a lot longer. You go to speed one, that's not gonna make your battery last longer. But it sure is going to push you down the road. But if you put it on number two, just a little burst will give you a lot more. And then if you give it a big burst, kapooey. Now, what else are these good for besides pushing you down the road? Best trolling motor I've ever had. It's easy. You just pop it on the boat. But also, if you're into making catfish nesties, like I am here at the Empty Nest Artisan Community, this right here is the Alabama Keys. There is a Key South. This one is Cypress, Key West. Way, way over yonder is Key East. And this is my pond. But here on Cedar Key West, we have put an old wilderness country tire upside down in here, and I'm gonna put it in here, and I'm gonna turn this sucker on, and we're gonna do what a catfish does naturally, making a nesting box. Now, I just got this started. Also, if you want to clean your water gardens, this is my koi pond that I built back in 2019, and I was still out there. Oh, got my finger in the way. I'm separating out clay, and this thing right here is really helping me stir up the mud and the muck. It goes in the sand. I've spent quite a few hours. I've hit rocks with it. Let's see what happens when I hit rock bottom with it. This may be the very best thing. And you ask what happens, what if it falls out of my drill? Well, they thought of that too. Because if it falls out of your drill, let me see if I can get it to come off the drill. First of all, it don't want to fall out of my drill. We rehearsed this. Stop. Dadgummit. If you're still watching, I guess you know what the Uncle Goat show's all about. How you turn this thing? There we go. I was turning it the wrong way. Golly bolly bum. If it falls out, somebody's going to have to edit this for me. If it falls out in the middle of the lake, are you screwed? Well, probably not. But, oh, I put it in reverse. Look at there. The best paddle floats. Now, if you're still here watching, we're gonna go right over here, and it just pops in easy. You can do it almost one-handed. We're gonna go over here to this other one of these other catfish nests, and shout out to that mean Tina down there in Tennessee. Guess what, girl? You inspired me to put in some noodling places so that people can actually noodle here in Northeast Alabama, Florida Keys. Look at these pretty sand drops. Let me get these things off here. But anyway, I've got another one right over here. I'm gonna stir it up this morning. All right, them catfish gonna be a happy critters. Here's one over here. Y'all can see a little bit more of what's going on. And then I'm gonna just put that in there. What's this drill paddle? Get it right in the mud. The owners of the drill paddle, if you're not rich, the American dream ain't real, because this is an amazing product. We'll see y'all later. Oh, there's some way out here. Let's go clean them out this morning. The drill paddle is what I use to clean the Alabama Keys in my koi pond and make catfish nest. And oh, and it's great for powering the canoe too. We'll talk to y'all later. Bye bye now. plays an amazing thing, isn't it, Joe? Look at that horse just gently coming out there. I'll leave y'all with a glance of the free-range ducks and maybe a little bit of a pond sweeping. See what my rocks look like under this. Got to push all this silt. There's a creek that'll flow and back through, flow through here, and I'm considering using this as a pump to keep my water running. Because let me show y'all this. If I want to clean off these rocks out here, let me show you how strong this thing can go when you get out here deep enough to where it don't hit the bottom, and give it a good full two things, and show you my creek started here. See, this is just on speed two and low. See if we can get these rocks washed back off. This is the clay coming out of those, and I'm storing it out here in 20 foot, 15 foot of water, and I'll be able to gather it back with buckets. Well, I'll put me a pump in, pump it up yonder, and we're going to do freshwater prawn, hopefully tilapia, and we're going to put them in the old totes and barrels, and possibly even make anyway, this is two. Now here's full speed. Look how it's pushing that mud and dirt. And when I want more mud and dirt or sand, it separates my sand out, so I've got these little beaches coming along my islands here. And yeah, I put this at the end of the video for a reason, because it's not time for everybody to see. Ellie Mae, you gonna take care of your baby chickens and duck? It's a little cool out here this morning. Take them in their house and warm them up. You ain't worried about it, are you, Ellie? You just hunting frogs, ain't you? Well, we'll see y'all later. Bye-bye now. I know, I'm a chronic lingerer. I keep on and on and on. See what we can do out through here. How far we can go. That's where little Bob sets and plays his guitar on Cedar Key West. He left the bucket up there. I guess we'll have to plant something new in it. Need to do an ASMR one day with the drill paddle. I'm working on an invention called the water bender for people with koi ponds and stuff. This is my backwash. It'll go backwards up in there. Now remember, next year the water level is going to come up over that key right there, over that rock, and up to the top of this. So we got to plan for accordingly. Like that park that comes out, our pond goes down close to this island every year. We've had good water this year, so every year it'll get a little bit better. And let me show you how I've done Tadpole Lagoon, since we're still making. Backwash. See, I can backwash my creek. It'll turn on. See how that water's going backwards out of there. Now, all of these little tires will go into an island. But watch right up there where that creek's starting up, just because I'm drilling backwards. So this drill paddle is able to make a lot of water flow. It's really amazing to me. And how does it handle rocks and silt and mud? Watch this. Gotta muddy your water to make it clean. And the reason it's clearing out so quick is I've got my bio bugs from my fish tank that I have got ready. And this is also gonna make some perfect fertilizer. Look at this right here. Tell me you could get better dirt for fertilizer than that right there. I don't think so. Look at that cloud of mud going out through yonder from that little number two that I, number two feed that is, that I give it out for that. A brown cloud from a number two. Wow. I think I'll leave on that. Look right here. This sandbar that is pushed up against the dam. It is actually when you get the silt off of it. Now this is sinky here because I ain't pushed it up. But this one, look, you can almost jump on it. Yes, Piper Lou, I have lost my mind by sweeping the pond. But I decided to work a little harder instead of smarter. I mean, a little smarter instead of harder with the drill paddle. And that does a whole lot more than a broom, but if you don't have a drill paddle, get you a broom, go out there and sweep a mud hole. Bye-bye now. Toto! Toto, no!